Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to the Chicago Cubs franchise series here in MLB 14, the show on the PS4. We are well into this National League Divisional Series. The Cubs up 2-1 on the San Diego Padres, looking to close things out. We sure as hell are not sending Travis Wood to the mound like it says right there. We're not taking that kind of chance. We already put Edwin Jackson out there. That didn't go well. So we are going to go to somehow the overlooked one so far, Chris Archer. I don't know how he didn't get the game one start. We gave that to Jeff Samardzija, but yeah, we're going to make good now. Get Chris Archer out there. I could have sworn we already pitched him in this series. I just assumed that the pitching rotation would have gone correctly there, but it hadn't. So Chris Archer gets the ball today and takes the mound against the Padres. We got a night game at Wrigley Field tonight. So as the two pitchers get ready, this is a big one. It's do or die for the Padres. If they win, they can send it back home for game five. But the Cubs have other ideas. So there is the starting lineup that Chris Archer will face. They're not hitting particularly well in the playoffs, although game three was much better. So Chris Archer, he of 16 wins on the season. Once again, somehow overlooked in our rotation. But here he is tonight. We're saving him. Stashed him for the game we really needed to have. So first inning, 0-2 count and two outs. Albert Pujols is going to chase that one out of the zone, strike three. Archer has a easy first inning. Nothing doing for the Padres. So we go to the bottom of the first for the Cubs. And it is Starlin Castro at the plate. He is going to ground out to short. Nothing doing for the Cubs either. Low throw there, but Pujols picks it. And the Padres are through their half of the first. So we go to the second inning, top of the second. And that changeup is low and away, but it is chased for strike three. It was well set up. 3-2 count, two outs. That's going to be hit, but that's a nice play there, backhanded by your first baseman, Anthony Rizzo, and the inning is over. So both pitchers starting strong, looking very strong. Question here today at Wrigley is who will crack first as far as the starting pitchers. Will it be Cashner? Well, this ball is hit well and over the left fielder's head. It will stay in the park off the ivy, and Jorge Soler will be in to second base with a double. So the Cubs might be the ones to scratch one home here first. We'll have to see if Cashner settles down. This is Wellington Castillo, and he's late on the fastball. Strike three. It's not going to be this inning, as Andrew Cashner is able to recover and get out of the second inning. So both pitchers throwing up goose eggs there. We got third inning now, and Archer back to the mound. 2-2 count. Strike three. Gets Cashner, his opposing pitcher, to strike out. National League ball. You get to pitch against those pitchers. That kind of helps. Going against Cameron Maben now. He's probably been the best bat in the lineup for the Padres in this series. He's going to ground out here, however, and nothing doing. Archer gets through the third. Still no score to date in this game tonight. Who will be the first? Chris Bryant at the plate. He's going to see this one nicely. Had a good count, and he's going to take this to the gap. Off the wall. He's hustling to second base. Good relay, but they're not going to get him. He's in there with a two-bagger, and the Cubs are particularly set up in this inning because that was a leadoff double. Now if they could just move him over and get him home, get that first run, they might be at a premium tonight, but uh-oh. Chris Archer's up, the pitcher. So, okay, maybe we bunt him over. Well, not with two strikes. 0-2 count. Wait a second. It's up the middle. Base hit into center field. Runner coming around to score. Chris Bryant is safe ahead of the throw. How about that? The first run is brought home by the pitcher, Chris Archer. How is that for helping yourself out? Cubs fans love it. Get him a jacket out of the dugout. He's got to run the bases now and see if he can come around and score. Still nobody out, and we turn over the lineup. Bonifacio, the leadoff hitter, is going to get a base hit to right. Now you got runners at first and second, and nobody out. Let's continue this on here. 3-1 count to Javier Baez. Nope, that's high. He's lost the command of the strike zone. Bases are loaded with nobody out. This could be not just an inning to score a run or two. This could be a disaster for the Padres. Castro hits this deep to center field. It's going to stay in the park, but this should be an easy tag up and score on the sacrifice fly. They'll try to cut down the runner at third. Not going to happen. So now you have just one out. It's 2-0 Cubs, and they've got runners at the corners. Can Cashner get outs here and keep this game close? Well, he's not going to get Rizzo. Rizzo's been hitting the ball well all series, and this one he's going to take out to center field for an RBI single. It's 3-0 Cubs, and there's still just one out. Pitching coach is alarmed on the situation here. He's coming out to talk to his pitcher, hopefully settle him down, but a hitter's count 2-1. Soler hits to third. Can they turn it? Oh, just what the Padres needed to stop the bleeding. They get a double play, but not before 3 runs come home. All right, we've given Archer some run support. Usually 3 runs will get it done for him. He's got a strikeout right there, as it's just strike 3 looking to Carlos Quentin, kind of upset with himself. Now a chance to turn 2. Not quite quick enough. Archer covering first. Not there in time, but a good effort on it. They get the lead runner, and they have 2 outs. So now with a runner on first, this is going to be hit to Chris Bryant. Backhands it, throws it to first. Inning is over. Once again, Archer goes out there and does not surrender a run. He's through 4 with a 3-0 lead, and the Padres starting to get a little bit frustrated. Where do we go from here? Well, the Cubs in the bottom of the 4th have Justin Ruggiano at the plate, and oh my, he unloads left center field, deep and back into those bleachers. It's gone, a solo home run. That makes it 4-0 Cubbies as Justin Ruggiano delivers. He did a lot of that this year, kind of surprising, brought the power, and it continues over now, finally, to the playoffs as well. What did he hit? I think 25 on the season. And a big one right here to pad the lead. So that allows Chris Archer to come out here with a 4-0 lead now in the 5th. That's a double play ball if they can turn it quickly. And they do. Gets out of that inning. And just like that, Chris Archer is through 5. Cubs fans starting to get a little nervous. They're checking around, making sure Steve Bartman's not in attendance. Got to keep him away from the railing if he is. That's a Anthony Rizzo base hit. Once again, he comes through. Have runners at first and second now. And another rally maybe for the Cubs. I don't think the Padres can afford to get much more behind than they are right now. 4-0, considering who's on the mound. That's ball 4 to Ruggiano. He's not hitting a homer this time, but they're not pitching to him either. Instead, they decide it's better to load the bases with 1 out. I don't know about that strategy. Might come back to bite him, but here is another double play ball started by the third baseman, and again, they get out of an inning that could have been much, much worse. So they're still in here in the 6th inning. 3-2 count with nobody out, and Chris Archer gets the strikeout. I believe he ends up with something like 6 or 7 for the ball game, and he's got 1 out now, but I said Cameron Maben's been a good bat in this lineup despite the Padres being down in the series. Well, he comes through with that hit, and he is motoring on into second base. No thoughts of hesitation there. He goes ahead and gets right into second, and hoping he has started a rally of sorts. Albert Pujols, a 1-1 count. Yeah, that pitch was supposed to be much higher in the zone. Instead, it gets a lot of the strike zone, and he takes it on out of here into the basket in the bleacher area, left center field, left field. It's gone. And it's a 2-run homer, and it cuts the lead in half now, 4-2. Let's see Pujols. You know, he is in the twilight of his career, I'd say. He's getting up there, but if you throw the ball there, he's probably more often than not still going to hit it out of the ballpark, and he does just that right there. So the Padres get a couple runs when they needed it the most. 2-2 count with 2 outs here. That's going to be popped straight up, and Chris Archer's calling it forward himself, calling off his infielders, and he makes the catch. Inning is over, so just the 2-run score. The Cubs would like to add a little insurance on in the 7th inning. 2-run game leaves possibilities open there, but Rizzo is finally going to get out. I think they've actually gotten him out a couple times today, but he does have a couple hits as well. So we're on to the top of the 8th, and Pujols, who has already homered, this time he gets under it. Big uppercut swing, and that's going to be a pop fly there to the shortstop that ends the inning. So we now go to the bottom of the 8th, the Cubs' last chance to tack on an insurance run. Here is a 1-2 pitch with 2 outs. Castillo gets that high in the air. That's going to be a fly out to center field. So it's going to come down to the top of the ninth. Get the closer warm. Ryan Madsen will take the ball and head to the mound, trying to shut this down and send the Cubs to the next round. Can he do it? Well, he's been pretty solid all year round. 1-2 pitch and strike three on the cutter. Quentin swings over it. That is strike one. Just two outs away now. 2-2 count with one out. And Venable is going to hit this one in the air. Should not be a problem. Ruggiano gets over there, backs up a couple steps, and makes the catch. Two outs. Just one out away from the Cubbies. Going to the NLCS. Can you believe it? Well, I don't know. But here it is happening. Strike two. Ryan Madsen just one strike away. Will he get him with a strikeout? Ground out? What? Just any out. Let's get him. Here's the pitch. Strike three swinging on the changeup. The Cubs win the series and will go to the National League Championship Series against either the Diamondbacks or the Atlanta Braves. We'll have to see who wins that series. But for right now, it is pandemonium at Wrigley Field. You don't get to see this that often. The Cubs advancing in the playoffs, so savor it, Cubs fans. They are moving on just one more step closer to the World Series. Could it happen? Could they break the curse on the 100th anniversary of Wrigley Field? Well, we already know it didn't happen in real life, but this is video game land. Anything's possible. Chris Archer, your MVP of the game. Seven strikeouts and some happy teammates. Yeah, there you go. Let's dance. Chris Archer's like, don't shove me into the reporter. Thank you very much. But the party rolls on here on the field. They'll carry this into the clubhouse. The Cubs have won. So let's turn our attention to the National League Championship Series. There's the notification that we've won the NLDS and we'll be taking on the Braves or the Diamondbacks. We just have to see which one it's going to be. It's all to be determined at this point. We'll just wait a couple seconds here. There it is. We'll be taking on the Arizona Diamondbacks, and we have home field advantage. Look at that. So this series will start at Wrigley Field on the 12th against Arizona. I hope, for the Cubs' sake, this is not the Arizona Diamondbacks team that has Joe Broadway hitting cleanup, or it might get a little messy. But unfortunately for the Diamondbacks, I don't think they have Mr. Broadway, and for the Cubs, that's a good thing. So tune in here, as in the next episode, we will start Game 1 of the NLCS. We'll see you then. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, go ahead and join the SGU team. Like the SGU Facebook page. Follow us on Twitter. Go ahead and subscribe to SGU here on YouTube so you don't miss daily videos. And last but not least, follow us on Twitch for live streaming goodness.